This presentation provides solutions to a common issue around battery chargers: why a battery is not charging. We will discuss some reasons you may be experiencing issues and some solutions to these problems. If you need more information following this video, please visit ti.com/chargers. Before we get into the issues for battery not charging, we want to give an overview of all the parts of the battery charging architecture. We start off with the system, which is the priority for the charging architecture. The system here is your device. Now, there are two sources to power the system: the input source and the battery. The input source provides power to the system when the adapter is plugged into the device, and the battery will take over when the input is not plugged in or when the input source is overloaded. Now, the input source acts as a power for the system, but also charges the battery as well. We also have the temperature profile here, which is important to make sure that the temperature of the charger is within safe charging range. We have other safety and protection like overvoltage, overcurrent, and safety timers. And for flexibility and control, we have the control interface, which can be standalone, I2C, or SMBus. Now, the three battery charging issues that we will talk about in this video are with the input source and control interface, the temperature, and the safety timers. This slide shows the lithium-ion battery charging profile. The green curve shows the battery voltage, and the blue curve shows the charge current during a battery charging cycle. Some things I want to highlight are the pre-charge, the fast charge, and the safety timer expiration. As you can see, to move from pre-charge to fast charge, you need your battery voltage to cross a certain threshold, either in this example 2.8 volts or 3 volts. And then you also have a safety timer expiration for the whole charge itself. The first set of issues we will be talking about for battery not charging are related to the input protection and control. The first issue is a not good input power. Three conditions need to be met in order to turn on the Regen LDO and start charging, which is shown in this top figure here: the UVLO, the sleep, and the ACOV. Now, these three coincide with these three bullet points for the not good input power. Now, the first bullet point I want to talk about for not good input power is that the battery charger may be in sleep mode because the input voltage, or the Vbus, is less than the voltage of the battery plus Vsleep. Now, this Vsleep is a headroom voltage that in this example is 80 millivolts. The second bullet point is that the charger may be disabled because the Vbus is under the UVLO threshold, which stands for the under voltage lockout. Now, you want to make sure that the input voltage is above this threshold when charging. Lastly, you may have an overvoltage situation where you have too much voltage in your input and the battery charger shuts down in order to keep the device safe. Now, the solution to these issues is you want to make sure that the power source is within the output voltage's acceptable range. Now, I want to go back to this bad source here. The bad source detection will pull 40 milliamps of current for 100 milliseconds from the input to ensure that the input power is good. Now, the second issue here is that your CE pin may not be equal to 0 or your CE bit may not be equal to 1. You want to make sure that you configure both the pin via hardware and the bit via software to make sure that they are in their correct states in order to enable charging. Now, lastly here, you also may have your LDO or Regen voltage below the regulation. If you look at the table here, for this example, if your input voltage is 9 volts, then you want your LDO voltage to at least be between 5.6 and 6.4. And with 5 volts here, you want it to be between 4.7 and 4.8. Now, there's this IREGEN, which is 40 milliamps for the 9 volts and 20 milliamps for the 5 volts. If you're pulling more than 40 milliamps or 20 milliamps of charge from the LDO, the voltage of the LTO will drop and will not be able to switch the converters. Now, a solution to this is you want to reduce the loading on the LDO to the below minimum allowed. The second issue we will talk about is related to the battery temperature. The issue here is that the battery temperature is outside of the safety range. As you can see from our figure here, you want your battery to be between T1 and T5. Anything between T1 and T5, the battery should be charging. Anything colder than T1 and anything hotter than T5, the battery will stop charging for protection reasons. Now the solution to this is you want to check the voltage of your TS pin. This will tell you if your temperature is within the acceptable range or not. You also want to note that either the gauge or the charge can monitor this, not both. Now the third set of issues we will be talking about are timer related. Now the first issue here we can see is that the pre-charge safety timer may have expired. Now this can happen when the pre-charge current isn't enough for the battery voltage to cross over to the charging with iCharge current. Now the solution to this is to increase that pre-charge current. For I2C, you can increase the pre-charge current with the register, but for a standalone charger with an external ISET pin, you want to use a parallel FET and a resistor to increase that charge. Now also, your fast time charger can expire. First and foremost, you want to make sure to identify the cause of that long charge time. You want to make sure you know exactly what's happening, because if there's a bad battery or something like that, your battery could overheat and there could be safety issues. Now once you've identified the cause, you can increase or disable that timer if the charger has an I2C interface. Also, you also want to monitor the status of the registers and the stat/in pins for a fault. When you find the fault, you can toggle the CE pin or the CE bit to restart that charge. So in summary, all issues really are solvable. We went over three major reasons for the battery not charging and their solutions. The first being the poor input source or the charger being in protection mode, the battery temperature being outside of normal charging range, and the safety timer expirations. That's the end of my presentation. Thank you.